you know, what I think it's just great that, you know, there's going to be like a potential secondary pool for kids to actually learn how to swim, in a pool that's conducive to it too, and more space. Yes. I think that's, I mean, it's huge. You know, people associate Carmel with swimming, you know, just kind of like around the country too. So it's really neat that we're expanding this not only to, you know, kind of the more elite groups that we have and we're so proud of, but also, you know, for the kids who are just learning how to swim.
Yeah, there has to be that entry point.
There has to, yeah, exactly. And like, I think a lot of it has been, you know, the swim, like the summer swim leagues and neighborhood swims, mm-hmm. You know, all around, but really it's, you know, now that we have that, have a one single place, that's awesome.
Yeah.
So hi, I'm Margaret Ramsey. I swam with Carmel Swim Club since I was in seventh grade until my high school graduation in 2012. So I currently live and work in New York City. I have two wonderful roommates and I work for SiriusXM Pandora in product and really love my job. And I've been at my job for almost 4 years now. Mm-hmm. Right after graduation, all my friends were moving to the city and I was too. So we all just kind of made it a little packed and here we are still today.
Nice.
Yeah, definitely. So my mom kind of got us into swimming, both me and my brother, from like a safety standpoint, mm-hmm. you know, she's like, if I'm ever not there, I want to make sure that you guys know how to stay afloat and get back to the wall. And it just kind of became a routine and something I really latched onto. I think I started with some just general, like my memories are, you know, an older woman teaching me how to swim in the pool, like in the early morning, like really cold all the time. And then I started getting into the summer swim team, mm-hmm. and kind of like summer neighborhood-y groups, and really enjoyed that. Found some really good friends, and, you know, really enjoyed kind of the competition part as well. It's just a fun way to introduce, you know, some healthy competition,
yeah.
and just some fun into the summer. So that's kind of my earliest.
That's awesome. Do you remember?
You know, I loved the team I was at before. Had great times and memories. It was just, I knew I wanted to take my swimming to the next level, mm-hmm. And, you know, seeing Carmel Swim Club on deck, you know, at every single meet, you just know that they're just a united group. They're buttoned up and mm-hmm. serious yet fun. They were doing well, and, you know, I wanted to be a part of that, and mm-hmm. I thought that I could really take my swimming to the next level if I chose Carmel. And I think that Carmel really opened a lot of doors for me, you know, both in my swimming and beyond, but really just kind of seeing them on deck and seeing how they were performing and just the people, I really was drawn to kind of make that switch to Carmel.
Very cool.
So the most significant lesson, and this is going to sound so cliche, but like, am I allowed to say courage and perseverance?
You can.
you know, these two words are really something that I saw when I was not on Carmel Swim Club. Mm-hmm. And then I also say it to myself probably weekly here today. Yeah. You know, they've always stuck with me. As, you know, when I was not on Carmel Swim Club, I was on another team and would see the shirts that everyone would wear. Again, looking like a united front and like a team, mm-hmm. a real team. And it was something that, you know, that team really embraced and embodied every time they were on deck. And, you know, I saw that and then I joined Carmel Swim Club and I was like, cool, I get to be a part of this now.
I get a shirt.
Yeah, and it's a shirt. I get like three colored shirts. Like, this is great. Mm-hmm. But it was something that, you know, it really stays with you because it, when I was on Carmel Swim Club, you know, the perseverance was getting up every morning, you know, 5-6 days a week. And then the courage to kind of, you know, look back and knowing before you stand on the block, you worked that hard. You mm-hmm. can get up and do this. So it's just, I mean, that's what it's meant to me you know, then was kind of the more day-to-day little things. And you know, now it's really about how I conduct myself, mm-hmm. You know, both in my professional and personal life. You know, I want to go above and beyond in my job, and I strive to do so. And I also know it takes a lot of courage to potentially move and shift that. Yeah. And, you know, just having that, like, I can do attitude and looking back at, like, what I've done and you know, where my journey has led me so far, and knowing that, you know, those two words, like, they really do stick with me.
Yeah.
And it's weird to say, but I still use it, and I always think of Carmel Swim Club, you know, when I think of those two words. And as soon as I associate it, you know, with Carmel Swim Club, it's, oh, I can do that, because I did, you know, two-a-days for 5 days a week.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I'm good.
Covered. Like, got that covered.
So, you know, it's meant a lot. You know, 16, it was doing those two-a-days 5 days a week, and now it's, you know, at 26, it's looking above and beyond, mm-hmm. and trying to do that in you know, every aspect of work and in my personal life.
Okay.
Yes. So I think, I mean, first of all, you guys were in the best position ever, like, most fun time in your life. You know, just walking through those double doors, you know, in the morning or afternoon, whenever your mom drops you off to practice, just look forward to every opportunity you get to walk into those doors. You know, even if you don't want to be there, you know, I remember someone told me to leave your baggage at the door and then walk in and have a fresh face. And if you do that, and you're just going to come out after practice so happy, knowing that you just spent a lot of time with your friends, your coaches, and doing something that you really love to do. So just kind of always look forward to walking in those doors every day. Oh, I'd say do it in a heartbeat. You know, as a kid, if that was kind of up to their, you know, their decision to join or not, I mean, why not? It's a great place to be. The people there all share some of your same kind of values and mentality, mm-hmm. and I think that's really important, to surround yourself with people who are like-minded, and especially like-minded for in a sport and in something that's challenging, and that you can also, you know, maybe you're 7 years old when you join Carmel Swim Club, and you get to see all of the Trish Reagans and Lauren Stouters of, you know, Lauren Jordans of the world, just right there on the pool deck. So it's really, you know, it's not just this little age group, it's everything. So I think that, you know, it's a great place to be as a kid, and also beyond, of course. And then I think as a parent, you know, why wouldn't you want your kid to be surrounded by this kind of support and mm-hmm. an hardworking group and, you know, great coaching staff, et cetera. Yes, I do have a favorite memory.
Okay.
I have a lot of memories and great memories. I think one kind of shines above the others, both for me personally and, you know, what it kind of meant for me to be on a team. Because swimming is a very individual sport, but it's also a very team-driven sport at certain times. You know, it really straddles that line.
Yeah.
And it's fun as an individual to do it, too, to kind of be that person that can be dynamic. And I think my favorite moment was when I got my Olympic trial cut in my 400 free.
Yeah.
We were at a meet at downtown at the Natatorium, so very comfortable. I'm used to swimming there all the time.
Yeah.
And it was a Grand Prix meet.
Yeah.
I was not, like, I somehow made it back to the C final. I was thrilled, and I was not expecting that. A lot of fast swimmers there, and I was like, oh, I guess I squeaked in. And it just so happened I was right next to Lauren Jordan, mm-hmm. my, you know, obviously good friend, teammate, and, you know, we were literally in every single training group and everything together. So
oh, yes.
Every lane, every practice, every lane. So we were kind of goofing off beforehand. Like, I'm sure we were in the warm down pool, like joking. I remember just always smiling or something, like laughing. Something was really funny to us. So we get up behind the blocks and, you know, we're just relaxed, hanging out, just ready to go get after it. And we were, you know, we dove off the blocks and we were basically right neck and neck the entire race. Yeah. And it was so much fun because, you know, while I love racing, I love the competition, it was more of just, this is practice. This is me and my teammate. This is us racing on a Saturday morning.
Yeah.
It just felt so natural and comfortable. I mean, there was a lot of uncomfortableness in the race.
Harder free, there's going to be. It was there better be.
Back, I'm like, ooh, this is really nice. But, you know, it was just fun. Yeah. And I think that's what Carmel Swim Club was to me, too. But this race in particular, and I remember just touching the wall. I had no idea what time I just went. So yeah. We kind of looked at each other, smiled, whatever, it's done. Looked at the scoreboard, and I was like, my job is robbed. I was like, oh, my gosh. I was like, I think this just happened. And then, you know, we both jumped across the lane line mm-hmm. and just embraced. And, you know, it was a very special moment. I think Lauren had definitely a few other trail cuts before that. This wasn't her first rodeo. But, you know, just seeing that support and that we did this together, mm-hmm. it was such a cool experience because, you know, we did this together yeah. and we were relaxed. And all of a sudden, all of our training just paid off, like mm-hmm. in those, you know, 4 or 5 minutes. And it was just really, really cool to do it with and right next to your teammate and training partner for years and years.
Very.
Honestly, I don't think there's a lot that's surprising about Carmel Swim Club. I mean, people know, you know, it's like when I was on the different team, I knew what Carmel Swim Club was. Yeah. And they were a hardworking group of just awesome people, all dedicated to the same, you know, goal. It doesn't matter if they were 7 or, you know, 14 and winning state championships. It, mm-hmm. you know, it didn't matter. Everyone was there for a purpose. You know, they're just a hardworking team that you want to be a part of. And I yeah. think, you know, not a lot of surprises. I mean, other than they, you know, we can let loose too yes. at some point, you know, like we're not all, we'll have our games and do some fun practices. You know, it's not just work, work, work. It's a really supportive environment to be in and to grow up in as well. Mm-hmm. But, you know, not a lot of surprises. It's just a good place to be, and I think that a lot of people know that nice. As well. But, you know, I think Carmel Swim Club is a great place to be at a very young age. Supportive, you have the best staff probably mm-hmm. like in the country, you know, teaching you how to swim and doing so with a lot of intent as well. Right. You know, everyone knows what they're doing there, and everyone has, I mean, a lot of people have already been through the Carmel Swim Club, mm-hmm. You know, team, and then are now giving back, and now that's their career. And I think that, you know, young people especially have a lot to learn from them. And I also think that, you know, friendships too are like a big thing
yes.
For Carmel. And, you know, going into, when I joined in 7th grade, you know, it was middle school. No one likes group. Everyone has their own groups in middle school.
Yep.
And here I was like, oh, here I am. Like, I don't know any one of you guys. But, you know, just how much everyone embraced each other. And as soon as you were on that team, you were part of the group, mm-hmm. you know. And it was just a real sense of community. And especially at Carmel High School, where, you know, I graduated with 1,200 people in my grade.
Mm-hmm.
You can really be kind of lost in high school. And I think that the swim team, whether you're a freshman or a senior, it gave you this huge sense of community and just walking down the hallway and knowing people and feeling comfortable. And it didn't matter what grade you were in.
Yeah.
It was just the friendships and the community that the team, you know, fostered was unbeatable. And I think that was really, really important to me, especially coming later into the team mm-hmm. and then also being able to give that back as well.